The Battle of Bilbo Baggins, first my And my question is, will you honor all of us for doing a live rendition of that?
Who sent you here? There's no shadow coming out. In the first place, when did I do that before? 1970? Am I right? Somewhere around 1970. During the making of the series, so this would have been around 1967, somebody from the Studio Business Affairs came to me and said, there's a man going to make a recording, an album of music, space music, Star Trek music, and they're going to put your picture as Spock on the cover. And they want to know if you want to do anything on the album. So I said, well, I think your Spock's going to be on the outside. Maybe something should be on the inside. So I went to New York and spent a couple of days and did some recording. I think there are 12 cuts on that album. I think I did six, three talk pieces and three songs. The album sold quite well, and the company, Dot Records, asked me to do some more albums. And we did a total of, I think, about six albums over the years. The gentleman who produced those albums was a man named Charles Brion. We became very good friends. And eventually he contacted me, I think we were done with those albums, and he contacted me and said, I got a song that I think you might have some fun with. And it was The Ballad of Bilbo Baggins. Well, I had been reading the trilogy, the Hobbit stories, and I thought, this is a fun thing, kids will enjoy it, it's a fun song. And it was about 30 years before the Lord of the Rings movie. We were way ahead of the curve on that movie. So I did it, and then we did a video of it. And now, because of the Ring trilogy, the movies, that thing has popped up all over the place. It's had over a million hits on the air. Is that you hitting it? So it goes in the middle of the earth, in the land of Shire, is a brave little hobbit whom we all admire, right? Wandering tight, fuzzy wooden toes, he lives in a hobbit hole, and everybody knows him. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, the bravest little hobbit of them all. That's all you get. Careful what you do in life, because it might come back to haunt you. No, I thought it was a lot of fun. I had a great time doing it, and I'm glad people are enjoying it. Yes, hi.
Hi. I came up from North Carolina.
Really?
Yes.
Yes. I was there not very long ago. I spoke at a resort place. I wish I could remember the name of it.
So do I.
I'm sure.
DeForest Kelly was the only person in the cast without an accent.
Oh, that's clever. Yeah. What a great guy! What a great guy! I have fun with him. He's a wonderful person. A wonderful North Carolina person. What did he go from North Carolina?
Georgia.
Close enough.
Up here, close enough.
Yeah.
The last time we talked was backstage at the Peachtree Playhouse in 1980.
In Atlanta.
In Atlanta. Yeah. After a wonderful performance of Vincent.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
And I have an appreciation for your photography as well. I'm an advertisement for you here.
Come on up here and let everybody see this photograph. Come on up here. This lady's wearing a t-shirt that has one of my photographs on it. You got it from the website, is that right? Come on up and stand up here behind me. This photograph was shot at the Hammer Museum in Los Angeles. It is my version of a painting by Henri Matisse called The Dance. And this was a group of burlesque performers who came from San Francisco and were working in Los Angeles on this particular date. And we brought them to the Hammer Museum and we got this photograph in the same kind of conformation as Henri Matisse's painting. And it's in the book called The Full Body Project. It's a story, the book is a photographic essay on the subject of